Charmaine Chartreuse lived in the Chartreuse Mansion, on the edge of town. Any visitors had to venture on foot to the top of the hill. The thick brush had long ago covered the driveway. The gate was usually unlocked. If not, the squealing wrought iron alerted anyone within miles that someone was entering the property. Charmaine had been left the estate by her parents. She herself was a friendly woman who knew everyone in town by name. She never imposed on anyone, but she never missed an opportunity to say hello and bid her neighbors a nice day. She looked forward to her daily walks to see the townspeople. Her first stop was always Mr. Plum's fruit stand. She'd often stand across the road and watch the activity at the store for a while before moving on her way. "If only she ate fruit," Plum would mumble to himself. "She wouldn't be so darn fat." Her favorite stop was Ivy's boutique. She particularly loved Ivy's selection of scarves. Every day, she'd stop in and admire them. Then on Friday, like clockwork, she'd buy the one she had been admiring all week. She would ask Ivy lots and lots of questions about scarves, like how to tie them and drape them. It was all very interesting to Charmaine. Ivy would shake her head after Charmaine left. "She's strange. She comes in every day to look at the same scarf and then buys it on Friday. She needs to get a life." Charmaine's spiky silver hair was daring and modern, and her nails were the longest in town. Every Wednesday, she had her nails done at Olivia's Nail Salon. Charmaine always tipped Olivia extra for that boy you have in college. Olivia appreciated Charmaine's money, but the moment she'd leave, Olivia would turn to the girls. "Do you believe her? That woman uses up a whole bottle of my polish every time. I don't know why she won't let me shorten those claws of hers." Every 2 years, Charmaine would repaint her house chartreuse green. Mrs. Grant from the Historical Society would roll her eyes. "This woman has no regard for history or tradition. I mean, it was a beautiful warm brown for so many years, for heaven's sake." Some nights, from the Chartreuse Mansion, Madame Butterfly could be heard above the dense fog, breaking the damp silence. Inside, Charmaine would dance and drink her favorite burgundy as she sang along with the music, always crying at the end. Once a week, Steve would deliver her groceries. He usually lingered for a few minutes to talk about art with Miss Chartreuse. His friends always asked him about the weird old drunk, but Steve would just change the subject. Miss Chartreuse never made fun of him for wanting to be a painter like his buddies did. When Charmaine Chartreuse came to the end of her life, the estate auction was a big event, and all the townspeople came. While people were milling around the property, a small group broke off from the crowd. They entered the barn, which had long ago been converted into an artist's studio. They stopped short. The barn was filled with Charmaine's paintings. The first one was a painting of Mr. Plum's fruit stand. It was quite remarkable in its detail. He recalled her standing there every day at his store. "This is breathtaking," Mr. Plum murmured. Olivia recognized the portrait of herself giving a manicure. She put on her glasses to read the title, "My Friend the Manicurist." Olivia removed her glasses and looked at Ivy, who was staring at Charmaine's magnificent paintings of her scarves. It was Charmaine's series of historical landmarks that caught Mrs. Grant's eye. She was impressed with their accuracy. It was then that Mrs. Grant made her decision. Charmaine left her home in the care of the Historical Society, and indeed it should remain chartreuse forever. Brown was, after all, quite common. But to Steve, Charmaine Chartreuse left her precious art supplies, for deep down, she knew he was an artist, and he was most pleased to have known an artist as fine as she.